Superb. Great concept. I like what you did. But what's up with the bridges? Did we move from being an ICT networking channel to civil engineering?
Well, first thing first, let me start by answering the deep voice me. The answer to your question is no, my guy. We are still an ICT networking channel. The bridge that we refer to in this instance is bridge interface, which is a logical interface, not a physical interface. It is not physically available on the hardware like your Ethernet ports, but physical ports can be assigned to it. It acts similar to a network switch. Meaning configuration applied to a bridge interface will be applicable to a physical interface. Welcome to Technology for All Academy, an academy that teaches information communication technology for free. To mention but a few, we have Cisco and Microtik series and will also be doing other vendor series in the future. For those who don't know me, my name is Thabang Makobe, the founder of Technology for All Academy. By now you should know ways to connect to your Microtik router, how to configure your IP address, and how to configure groups and users. If this is your first lesson, make sure to watch previous lessons as they teach things that I spoke about. In our lesson today, we are going to learn how to configure bridge interface and DHCP. We'll be using both Winbox and PuTTY. I'm going to start with bridge interface because I've already spoke about it. Let me start by opening my Winbox. To connect to my Microtik router, I'm going to click on my IP address and then connect. And inside the Winbox, I'll go to bridge and I'll click on the addition sign to add a bridge. We'll leave the name of the bridge as bridge 1. We won't change the name. And then I'm going to click OK. Now that I have my bridge, the next step that I must do is to assign ports to my bridge. And to do that, I'm going to click on the ports tab on above menu and click the addition sign. And it will open for me the new bridge port interface or GUI. So what I'm going to do inside this graphic user interface under general, that's where I'm going to assign my port. Like for example, right now interface, we have wireless LAN 1 and then the bridge, we can see it's bridge 1. So I'm going to say OK to add wireless 1 and then click the addition sign again. Now I'm going to change my interface to ETH 2. ETH 1 we are not going to apply inside the bridge because we want to use it for internet. It will be connected to our ISP. Click OK. Now go to add ETH 3. Okay, going to also add Ethernet 4, click OK. And with that, we have finished to configure our bridge and adding or assigning ports to our bridge on Winbox. We're also gonna configure the bridge interface on PuTTY later. What is DHCP? DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Control Protocol. It's a way of leasing IP addresses. Our DHCP server will be configured in a way that it will be having IP scope that it will be able to lease to its clients. So without wasting time, let me configure DHCP and show you how does it work. So let's go back to our Winbox. Let's start by configuring DHCP client. And the way to configure DHCP client, we go to IP, DHCP client, and then in the graphic user interface that's open, we click the addition sign. And then we choose the interface where we want to apply the client. In our case, as we've said, we want Ethernet 1 to be connected to the ISP. So I'm going to choose ETH 1 to be a DHCP client. And we're going to use peer DNS, peer NTP. And also we are going to get the default route from the ISP. So I'm going to click OK. And then I'm going to click on my ETH 1 and I'm going to click on the right arrow. As you can see, We have an IP address from our ISP, which is 10.10.100.64. To check that we have internet, I'm going to go to tools, then ping. And I'm going to ping 8.8.8.8. And let me start my ping. As we can see, it's responding, meaning we have internet. So I'm going to stop my ping. Now that we are finished configuring our DHCP client, let's configure our DHCP server. And ways to do that is to go to IP, DHCP server, and we click on DHCP setup. It will open the DHCP setup GUI. On the graphic user interface, that what we are going to do, DHCP server interface, we want our interface to be bridge 1. And you go to next, DHCP address space, yes, is the right network. Next, gateway for our DHCP network, it's 10.10.10.1, that's true. Address that you want to give out, we want to give from .2 up to .254. So it's also correct. DNS server, yes, that's the DNS server that you want to use. And the list time, 10 minutes, it's fine as it is. So we have successfully set up our DHCP server. And to see if it's listing addresses to our clients, let me go to my computer, network and internet setting, click on my Ethernet, change adapter options. I'll double click my network interface card to open it, go to properties, and inside the properties, I'm going to internet protocol version 4. So what I'm going to do, I'm gonna click on obtain an IP address automatically, obtain DNS server address automatically, press OK, and let me close everything. Then after this, let me connect to my Winbox again, since I closed it. And then inside this DHCP server graphic user interface, let me click on leases. As you can see, our DHCP server is working. We have a client that got 10.10.10.254, which is my PC. It got an IP address from my DHCP server. Now that we are finished with Winbox configuration, let me open my party and then I'll type my IP address, which is 10.10.10.1. Open. My username is labtest. Labtest. Enter. Password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Enter. And we are inside our command line interface. The first thing that I want to start with is to show our port that are inside the bridge. So to do that, I'm going to give the command interface bridge port print and then enter. This is the command that will display your ports that are inside the bridge. As you can see, we have wireless LAN 1, Ethernet 2, Ethernet 3, and Ethernet 4. And we configured all of them on our Winbox. And we can see that Ethernet 2, it's H, meaning hardwire offload. Wireless LAN 1, it's inactive. And 2 and 3 are also inactive, hardware offload. So what I'm going to do right now, I want to delete these interfaces inside the bridge so that we can configure them again. So to do that, I'm going to say interface bridge port remove. The numbers, it's 0, 1, 2, and 3. Enter. And then let's give the command interface bridge port print again and see if we still have our interfaces. We don't have interfaces anymore. Another thing that I want to do is to delete our bridge. So to do that, firstly, let me display our bridge. And to display our bridge, the command is interface bridge print enter. As we can see, we have our bridge. The name is bridge 1. So to remove our bridge, I'm going to give the command interface bridge, remove, number, 0, enter. Then let's do interface bridge print again. You can see right now we don't have a bridge. So what are we going to do now? Let's start by configuring our bridge, and after that we'll assign the post to our bridge. And to do that, going to give the command interface bridge add and name is equal to let's make it bridge one again. Bridge one, enter. We have configured our bridge, and to assign the post to the bridge, it's interface bridge port add bridge is equal to, the name is bridge one, interface is equal to wireless LAN 1, enter. Then we hit the up arrow. Let's delete wireless LAN 1 and then make it Ethernet 2, enter. Let's hit the up arrow again. Right now, let's make it Ethernet 3, enter. We hit the up arrow again and Ethernet 4, enter. Now, let's do interface bridge port print to see if our ports have been configured. As you can see, we have our ports configured and they are inside bridge 1. Right now, we know how to configure bridge and assign ports both on Winbox and on our command line interface on party. Let's carry on with our lesson, and right now we're going to configure DHCP on command line. We also gonna start by removing or deleting the configuration that we did on Winbox and then configuring it again on the party. So to do that, let's start with DHCP client, and I'll give the command DHCP client print. And then we have our DHCP client there. It's eth1 with IP address 10.10.100.64. So I'm going to give the command IP DHCP client remove 0, enter. And then let's hit the up arrow, give the print command again. As we can see, we don't have a client anymore. And now let's move to DHCP server configuration. And I will start by giving the print command. And to give it, it's IP DHCP server print. As we can see, we have our DHCP server, and the interface is using is bridge one. So now I'm going to remove or delete my DHCP server, and to do that, I'm going to give the command IP DHCP server remove 0, enter. And let's hit the print command again and see if we still have our DHCP or not. As we can see, we don't have our DHCP anymore. So right now what we are going to do, we are going to configure our DHCP client and our DHCP server. But before we can start configuring the DHCP client, I want to ping 8.8.8.8 again, which is the Google DNS server, to see if we can still go to the internet. So to do that, I'm going to give the command ping 8.8.8.8, enter. As we can see, there's nothing happening. So I'll hit Control C to end my ping. So now let me start by configuring my DHCP client. And to configure our DHCP client, going to give the command IP DHCP client add disable. We say no, that's how we enable our client. And then interface, we are using Ethernet 1 and then enter. Let's see if our client has been configured. And to do that, we give the command IP DHCP client print, enter. Yes, we have our IP DHCP client, and the address is 10.10.100.64/24. As it was before, it's on eth1. Let's try to ping 8.8.8 again and see what will happen. Right now we are going through, we are able to go to the internet. Control C, and we are done with configuring our IP DHCP client. Now on our IP DHCP server, we're gonna have to configure our scope, IP address scope. We're gonna have to configure our DHCP server. And you also gonna have to to configure the network and gateway for our DHCP server. And to do that, I'm going to start with our IP DHCP scope, our scope of addresses. And to do that, I'm going to give the command IP pool add name, we'll make it lab scope range. Our range will start from 10.10.10.10 to 10.10.10.254. Enter. And then the second thing that we need to do is to configure our DHCP server. And to configure our DHCP server, I'm going to give the command IP DHCP server add disable no address pool. Our address pool is LabScope interface. We're going to apply it on interface bridge 1. And the name will give it DHCP 1. DHCP 1. Enter. Last but not least, we are going to assign the network and default gateway to our DHCP server. And to do that, we're going to give the command IP DHCP server network add address is equal to 10.10.10.0/24, and our gateway is equal to 10.10.10.1. And when you press enter, with those three things configured, we are done configuring our DHCP server, and it can now be able to lease IP addresses to our clients. And to show that it is possible to lease IP addresses, we're going to go to our network interface card and change it to DHCP server mode. So I'm going to click on my network and internet settings, Ethernet, change adapter options, click on our network interface card, properties, IPv4, and then there it is, obtain an IP address automatically, obtain the DNS server address automatically. Okay, now let me go to my command line, cmd, enter, and then I'm going to type ipconfig, enter, and then as you can see, there it is, we have the address 10.10.10.255, is the address that we got from our DHCP server. Let's check if our PC will be able to ping 8.8.8, and then let's do that, ping 8.8.8.8. And I'm definitely sure it won't be able to go through. But let's see. As you can see, it's giving request timeout. And if you want to know the reason for that, make sure you subscribe and click the like button so that you can be notified when you drop our next lesson. Because on our next lesson, we'll be covering why our client is not going to the internet while our router is able to connect to the internet. If you find this video informative, make sure you share it with someone you think will also benefit from it. Let me love and leave you. Have a nice day.